Hallo, Servus und herzlich willkommen zu einer weiteren Episode von Doki Doki Literature Club. Und ja, ich muss an dem Anfang gleich mal kurz sagen, ich habe jetzt bis zu einem bestimmten Punkt tatsächlich schon gespielt gehabt. Und das Problem war tatsächlich einfach, dass der Sound so hart rumgespackt hat, dass ich das nicht nehmen konnte. Das heißt, es hat halt die ganze Zeit gerasselt, gerauscht und so weiter. Und es sollte jetzt besser sein. Ich habe da jetzt mindestens eine Stunde dran gesessen, um das zu verbessern. Deswegen werde ich mich auch während der Aufnahme nicht mehr bewegen, sondern steif am PC sitzen. Und wenn es rumspacken sollte, dann kriege ich einen Anfall, weil das ist, wie gesagt, jetzt zweite Aufnahme. Wie gesagt, ich kenne den Teil, aber ich wollte ihn natürlich euch auch zeigen. Deswegen muss es halt jetzt so sein. Deswegen, ich habe da jetzt 30 Minuten gespielt, das heißt wahrscheinlich, die Episode wird ungefähr 30 Minuten sein. Deswegen, ich kenne den Text schon, ihr nicht, ich wollte es trotzdem euch zeigen, deswegen, ja, starten wir jetzt einfach. Even wincing from the pain, Sayori makes a silly joke. Haha, what are you saying? I'll be right back, okay? Okay. Dann machen wir das jetzt hier einfach nochmal und wie gesagt, ich bin nicht glücklich darüber, absolut nicht, weil es war tatsächlich einfach gut gewesen. Vom Commentary her. Deswegen bin ich ein bisschen enttäuscht, aber na gut. Pat Sayori on the shoulder and run into the hallway. I locate the nearest vending machine. What should I get? Doesn't really matter, since it will be used as an ice pack rather than to drink. But I know Sayori likes apple juice, so I purchase that one. In just a moment I'm already returning to the classroom where I left Sayori. Wie gesagt, ich rede jetzt vielleicht kommt es auch ein bisschen leiser von der Stimme hervor, weil ich jetzt nicht reinschreien will. Ich will mich gerade so gut wie nicht bewegen, damit es nicht umgestellt wird. She has one palm on her forehead and is using the other hand to clumsily scoop crayons from the back into the box. Ich sag nicht, dass mein Englisch gut ist. Das habe ich nie gesagt. At least they were already in the wrong place, wrong spots before I spilled them. Sayori here. I hand Sayori the bottle of apple juice. It's nice and cold. Sayori opens the cap and starts drinking from it. Sayori, what are you doing? It's for you, forehead idiot.
Ah! Sorry, I forgot. Ah!
How hard did you hit your head? Sayori places the bottle against the pump on her head.
It stinks!
Just bear with it. It will feel better soon. Looks like you cleaned up most of the crayons. That's good.
Hey, Hilliard! This kind of reminds you of growing up, doesn't it?
What do you mean?
You know, how we used to play outside all the time. I would always try to keep up with you. We're kind of oblivious in some ways. Like I usually fell behind or had trouble climbing on things you did. But sometimes when I tried to do the things I couldn't, I would get hurt myself. Myself hurt. I'd fall and scrape myself or get a bump. And I would start crying really hard. Ah, ha, ha. And you would rush over as quick as you could. You would try really hard to get me to stop crying. It was almost like you blamed yourself and were afraid of getting in trouble if someone found out. Even though it really wasn't your fault at all, you know?
Did I really do that?
Yeah, you don't remember?
Come to think of it, maybe I remember a bit. I guess I always was so focused on my games that I didn't pay enough attention to you. So in a way, it was my fault. Kind of like this time too. If I wasn't rushing you out of the closet, you probably wouldn't have hit your head.
Hilliard, I don't think you realize it, but you're always thinking about other people. Even after all these years. You're rushing to help me, even though I'm just being clumsy. You're really a sweetheart.
Don't call me that. Übrigens, meine Stimme ist hart im Arsch. Also wie gesagt, ich habe die Aufnahme ja auch schon gehabt. Und das heißt, meine Stimme ist nicht besser. Ich wollte sogar zwei Folgen hintereinander aufnehmen. Es hat nicht funktioniert. Wie gesagt, es nervt mich unfassbar hart. Und deswegen, ich werde mich ja wahrscheinlich noch häufiger drüber aufregen. Und deswegen, wenn das Commentary in der Folge nicht so gut ist, bitte verzeiht's mir. Ich habe da jetzt tatsächlich nicht nochmal Lust, dieselben witzigen Witze zu machen, die nicht witzig sind. Ich hoffe, ihr könnt es nachvollziehen. Ich hoffe, in der nächsten Folge wird es dann auch für beide Seiten frisch und neu zur Sache gehen. Don't call me that. Ada, don't really do this kind of things all the time. I guess when it comes to you, I just feel natural. Before I even know it, I'm treating you like that. I guess that's what happened when you've been friends for so long.
Really? Maybe you're right. Really good.
I
I'm so glad that nothing changed between us. Do you think it will be like this forever?
Forever? If I'm honest to myself, there's no telling where we'll be each up and up for college or after that. So it wouldn't be fair for me to make any promises. But, well, I hope so. Ich trinke mal kurz einen Schluck. Meine Stimme nicht komplett im Arsch ist. It's been this long already, right? I can't imagine you ever changing to my hopes are up.
I'm so happy.
Sayuri has a whimsical expression in her eyes. We remain silent for a moment. She's so silly and clumsy on the outside that when I see her deep in woe like this, it makes me not to want to disturb her. I guess we should go back. I don't want to worry Monica, you know? Oh, warte, verdammt, ich habe die Stimme jetzt vergessen, mein Gott. Good luck with that. He's gonna see your forehead either way.
Not if I hide it under my bangs.
Oh, well. Sayuri hops up to her feet.
Ah!
She clutches her forehead again. Don't stand up so fast after hurting yourself. Well, I guess it's too late now. Anyway, let's go. Ich will nur kurz sagen, das habe ich auch schon anders gesagt. Die hat sich den Kopf gestoßen, hat da jetzt eine Beule am Kopf. Und es wird so dargestellt, als wäre die irgendwie im Vietnamkrieg gewesen, hat irgendwie drei Körperteile, irgendwie Arm und zwei Beine verloren, wo sie sich nur um den Kopf gestoßen hat. Danke für gar nichts, würde ich mal sagen. Anyway, let's go. I follow Sayuri out of the classroom. Sayuri plays with her bangs to try to hide the bomb but without much success. Beim ersten Mal habe ich es auch besser vorgelesen, merke ich gerade. In a moment we make it back to the clubroom.
Oh, you're back. Good timing with Joseph as ready to start sharing your poems. Sayuri footed.
It's fine, don't worry about.
I was playing with the crayons and smacked my forehead into the shelf.
Well, anyway, we were able to find everything we needed.
Well, I have it right. Eh?
Sayuri frankly glanced around herself. Frantically. Alter, ich hasse englische Wörter zum Teil manchmal so hart.
I forgot all the stuff.
Come down, Sayuri. I have it all right here. Wir sind schon schlauer. Wenn sie schon nicht mitnimmt, nehmen wir es mit. Immerhin etwas. I found the poster paper too.
Oh ho ho. Ho ho. Sounds like you ended up doing all the work you get.
Ah, where's Sayuri? I failed to come up with an excuse for Sayuri.
I made it an adventure.
Yeah, that.
Oh ho ho. Okay, okay. In any case, good work. I'll start working on the pages tonight.
Me too.
Okay, everyone. Hey, let you share your poems. Guess I should grab mine,
mein Gott. Ich bin schon ein bisschen müde, es tut mir furchtbar leid. After making sure the crane's box is closed tightly, I return to my seat. Ich werde am nächsten Tag die zwei nächsten Folgen aufnehmen. Hoffentlich. Und ich mache es auch wie im letzten Video, 1:1. Should I read my poem first? Sayuri.
Hilgert, I really love your poems. I can't believe you've been hiding these from me.
I'm not hiding anything.
But your poems are so good. Yesterday and this one's too. You can't tell me you haven't done this before.
I mean, you're really the only one who feels that way, so...
Eh? No way. Not even Natsuki?
Well, I guess Natsuki is the least likely to admit how much she likes something. But I don't think it's that.
What do you mean?
Well, I guess I'll be honest about it. It's a lot easier to write poems when I'm thinking about you.
Eh? What?
Stop thinking weird things, idiot. I just mean that you're a really expressive person, I guess. How am I supposed to write poems about my own stupid life? But you somehow make everything in your life an adventure. Even the little things.
Like cooking.
Let's not talk about that. So yeah, I guess what I'm saying is that I can feel more feelings through you than I can through myself. We have that kind of weird connection. It's your fault for getting in my business all the time.
Eh? I don't know if I understand.
You never understand why I'm trying to explain things to you. Do you, Sayuri? Pet Sayuri said.
Hey! I'm not a kid, you know?
Are you sure about that? Are you sure about that? Da fällt mir diese wunderschöne Internetreferenz mit John Cena ein. Und das war beim ersten Mal lustiger.
Maybe.
Sarah starts fiddling with her pencil between her hands.
Hey Hagrid, will you give me a poem? I kinda want to keep it.
Why?
Cause, well, it's the first you've written something for me.
Sorry, you completely misunderstood. I didn't write this for you. Are you even listening anymore? Well, whatever. I will give it to you when we go home.
Really?
Warte, hört man das? Hört man bestimmt.
I broke my pencil.
Sayori hastily bends to pick up the piece she dropped. But being inattentive of her surroundings, she bumps right into me.
Sorry.
It's fine, it's fine. I'll get it for you. I bend down to pick up the broken pencil. Sayori clutches the desk beside her to support herself near its shaking.
I'm a little clumsy today. Yeah.
Let's sit down, Sayori.
Yeah.
I grab Sayori's arm and help her sit at the desk. Anyway, I still haven't read your poem. Oh?
Sorry, I forgot about it. But it's not as good as yours.
Jeez, don't worry. I'm sure we'll like it.
So, ich hab das, wie hab ich das in dem ersten Ding vorgelesen? Das ist nämlich relativ lang.
Bottles, I pop my scalp like the lid of a cookie jar. It's a secret place I keep all my dreams. Little bars of sunshine are rubbing together like a bundle of raccoons. I reach inside with my thumb and forefinger and pluck one out. It's warm and tingly, but there's no time to waste. I put it in a bottle to keep it safe, and I put the bottle on the shelf with all of the other bottles. Happy thoughts, happy thoughts, happy thoughts in a bottle, all in a row. My collections makes me lots of friends, each bottle a starlight to make amends. Sometimes my friends feel a certain way, down comes a bottle to save the day. Night after night, more dreams, friend after friend, more bottles. Deeper and deeper my finger go, like exploring a dark cave, discovering the secret hiding in the nooks and crannies. Digging and digging, scraping and scraping, I blow dust off my bottle caps. It doesn't feel like I'm elapsed. My empty shelf could use some more. My friends look through my locked front door. Finally, all done, I open up, and in come my friends. In they come in such a hurry. Do they want my bottles that much? I frantically pull them from the shelf, one after the other, holding them out to each and every friend, each and every bottle. But every time I let one go, it shatters against the tile between my feet. Happy thoughts, happy thoughts, happy thoughts. In charts, all over the floor. They were supposed to be my friends who aren't smiling. They're all shouting, bleeding, something, but all I hear is echo, 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 echo inside my head.
So, das habe ich beim ersten Mal auch voll besser vorgelesen. Bei den nächsten Parts werde ich mir, wie gesagt, wieder mehr Mühe geben, aber ich glaube, ihr könnt es alle verstehen, dass ich nicht unbedingt Bock drauf habe. Jo, also. Holy crap. Sorry, did you really write this?
Of course I did. Didn't I tell you yesterday I was gonna write the best poem ever?
Yeah, but I mean, I didn't expect something like this coming from you.
Monica taught me a whole lot, and I've been really into touch with my feelings recently.
I see that. It's almost kind of creepy.
Creepy?
Well, not exactly. Maybe because I'm so used to you being cheerful. Well, never mind. I'm thinking too hard about it. The point is, it came out good. You should be proud of it.
Oh, thanks. I feel like I was meant to express myself this way.
Alter, meine Stimme kackt echt hart ab.
Leave me helps me understand my own feelings a little bit better. Writing is like magic.
Magic. Magic.
You've gotten pretty passionate about this, huh? I hope you keep it up.
Yeah! Writing is the best! I'm gonna keep on writing until I die!
Don't get ahead of yourself. Sorry, I always had a habit of getting obsessed with something before dropping it no more than a week later. I wonder if this is one of those times. But seeing the passion in her eyes makes it hard for me to be pessimistic. Ich trinke noch einen Schluck. Als nächstes habe ich Yuri genommen, tatsächlich. Die Schrift kann ich immer noch nicht lesen, aber egal. Let's see what you've been... Nee, warte, das war britisch. Nee, warte mal, wie mache ich das? Let's see what you've been holding for today. Yuri says at a poem with a surprised expression on her face. Do you like it?
Hilgit. How did you pick up on this so quickly? Just yesterday, I was telling you the kind of techniques worth practicing.
Maybe that's why. You did a good job explaining. I went to try giving it more imagery. Yuri invisibly swallows. Even her hand appears sweatily. Sweaty.
I'm not used to this.
Used to what?
I don't know.
It's fine, take your time. Yuri breathes and collects her thoughts. I know that Yuri likes to think before she speaks, so I offer that patient to her.
Yeah. Just being appreciated like this, I guess. It probably sounds really stupid, but seeing someone motivated by my writing just makes me really happy.
Are you saying you never shared your poems writing before? Yuri nods. Really? I don't believe it.
I really only write for myself, and besides, people would just laugh at me.
Do you really think that? Again, Yuri nods. Huh. Even your close friends? Yuri doesn't respond to that.
I wonder why.
Anyway, do you want to share the poem you wrote today?
Yeah, I do. If it's with you.
Wie gesagt, die Stimme kann ich gar nicht. The Raccoon. It happens in the dead of a night while I was slicing bread for a guilty snack. My attention was called by the scuttering of a raccoon atop my window. That was, I believe, the first time I noticed my strange tendencies as an unordinary human. I gave the raccoon a piece of bread, my subconscious well aware of the consequences. Well aware that a raccoon at its feet will always come back for more. The inciting beauty of my cutting knife was the symptom. The bread, my hungry curiosity. The raccoon, an urge. The moon, it cements its face and reflects that much more light off my cutting knife. The very same light that glitches in the eyes of my raccoon friend. I slice the bread, fresh and soft. The raccoon becomes excited. Or perhaps it's manly projecting my emotions onto the newly satisfied... Oh, da ist mir selbst rausgekommen. Stößchen. A satisfied animal. The raccoon has taken to following me. You could say that we've gotten quite used to each other. The raccoon becomes hungry and more frequently, so my bread always handy. Every time I brandish my cutting knife, the raccoon shows me its excitement. A rush of blood. Classic perfectly conditions. Conditioning? Slice the bread and I feel myself again. Ah ja. Also wie gesagt, Raftalia haben wir hier auf jeden Fall im Gedicht. Das ist doch sehr schön. Wie gesagt, ich habe das auch beim ersten Mal nicht verstanden. Ich verstehe es jetzt auch nicht besser. Aber das Leitmotiv, habe ich glaube ich verstanden, ist ein Cutting Knife.
I was a little more daring with this one than yesterday's.
I can see that. It's a lot more metaphorical. I don't know if it's my fault, but I can't begin to imagine what this poem is about.
That's right. It's a bit closer to my preferred writing style. Using the poem as a canvas to express vivid imagery and conveying emotions through them.
Yeah, if it take at a face value, then I can't even figure out what it's supposed to mean.
Well, I think it's something that different people can relate to in their own way. I wanted to express the way it feels for me to indulge in more unusual hobbies.
It's those sort of things I'm usually forced to keep to myself. So I sometimes enjoy writing about them.
Why do you keep them to yourself?
Because they're embarrassing. And people would make fun of me. Don't you have anything like that, Hilgert?
Well, yeah, I guess I do.
I really feel like everyone has a little something like that. The best we can do is respect each other and our individualities. Even it's difficult sometimes, and some things make us uncomfortable. After all, if I hadn't learned to embrace my own weirdness, I would probably hate myself. I might be ranting a little bit now, but I'm glad that you're a good listener. So,
das war schon mal mit Yui perfekt.
I like the last one better.
Oh, really?
Well, yeah, I can tell you we're a little bit more daring with this one. Are you really not good enough for that yet? I feel flat.
That may be true, but I just wanted to try something different. I'm still figuring this all out.
I mean, I always like poems that aren't trying too hard. I hate when people try to sound fancy or add more meaning just by using annoying and complicated language.
Boah, Alter, ich kann die nicht gut vorlesen heute. Ich entschuldige mich jetzt schon zum dritten oder vierten Mal. Es tut mir furchtbar leid, aber das mit dem Vorlesen ist heute grässlich.
Just make it simple, cute, and to the point.
Get to the point.
Yuri, heads over heels. All this cryptic nonsense, but I see right through that BS. Ha! Making your arena look so hard for all this deep meaning. It's just an excuse to have no meaning at all.
I guess that's one way to look at it.
Well, everyone has their own opinion. But my opinion is the best opinion. I'm sure you've figured that out already.
Anyway,
here's my poem. Maybe you'll learn something.
Boah, die lächelt ja sogar mega krass.
Amy likes spiders. You know what I heard about Amy? Amy likes spiders. Itchy, wrinkly, hairy, ugly spiders. That's why I'm not friends with her. Amy has a cute singing voice. I heard her singing my favorite love song. Every time she sang the chorus, my heart would pout to the rhythm of the words. But she likes spiders. That's why I'm not friends with her. One time I hurt my leg really hard, really bad. Amy helped me up and took me to the nurse. I tried not to let her touch me. She likes spiders, so her hands are probably gross. That's why I'm not friends with her. Amy has a lot of friends. I always see her taking off friends. She probably talks about spiders. What if her friends start to like spiders too? That's why I'm not friends with her. Doesn't matter if she has other hobbies. Doesn't matter if she keeps it private. Doesn't matter if it doesn't hurt anyone. It's gross. She's gross. The world is better off without spider lovers. I'm gonna tell everyone.
Das Ding ist halt, ne? Ich habe das auch am Anfang tatsächlich falsch verstanden, als ich das erste Mal gelesen habe. Und beim zweiten Mal verstehe ich es tatsächlich besser. Toll. Es ist zum Kotzen, dass ich das jetzt. Jetzt ist sie halt nicht mehr blind, ne? Das ist halt zum Kotzen.
Bad, right?
It's quite a bit longer than yesterday's.
Yesterday was too short. I was just warming up. I hope you didn't think that was the best I could do.
No, of course not.
Anyway, the message is pretty straightforward in this poem. I doubt I have to explain it. Sometimes I can explain complicated issues with much simpler analogies. And it helps people to realize how stupid they've been. Like anyone would agree that the subject of this poem is an ignorant jerk.
You know people like that?
Of course, it's about how everyone thinks my... That doesn't matter. It can be about anything. I wrote it to be easy to relate it to. Everyone has some kind of weird hobby or a guilty pleasure. Something that you're afraid of if people find out and make fun of you or think less of you. But that just makes people stupid. Who cares what someone likes as long as they're not hurting anyone and it makes them happy? I think people really need to learn to respect others for liking good things.
Oh, that's funny. You wrote something about something similar today.
Huh? Did you say Yuri?
Yeah. She said her poem was about an unusual hobby of hers. I didn't really get it, but she said something similar to you. people should make each other feel insecure about those things.
Really? Well, I mean, Yuri's pretty weird, so I would doubt that she has some weird hobbies. But there's anything wrong with that. It's not like I would judge her or anything.
Matsuki has trouble finding words.
I guess you should try not to be mean to her. If she feels insecure about her weird behavior and stuff, I mean, I always hate people. Makes me feel insecure. And you make me feel insecure yesterday. But the way you put it, sounds like she learned her lesson.
Well, I would say so. Even if her writing style is really different, I'm sure she will appreciate the message in your poem.
It's what I do the best after all. I don't like writing unless there's a good message to take away from it. Like convenient emotions is important. But I want to make people think, not just feel. Remember that. Gonna write a good one for tomorrow too, so look forward to that.
Oh, ich wünschte, ich könnte die besser vorlesen heute.
Ich bin nicht glücklich, wie gesagt. Jetzt kommen wir mit Monika. Das ist nicht so schwierig vorzulesen. Hi, Gunhild. How's the wall writing going? Alright, I guess. I'll take that. As long as it's not going bad. All heavy that you're applying yourself. Maybe someone will come up with a masterpiece. I wouldn't count that. Who'll never know. Want to share your poem with us today? Sure, here you go. I give my poem to Monika. Oi. It's pretty good. Makes me think of the Miyori like the other one that you worried. Tura like a dynamic do. That's kind of exaggerating it. Yeah, probably. Well, you should spend a lot of time with her even in this club, didn't you? Then again, I'll don't blame you for being a little shy. I'm not shy, it's just... I'm just teasing. I know it won't make you... I know it takes a bit of time to make friends with anyone. But you already know you are super interesting people, so don't be afraid to giving their deserved time. And you can talk to me every now and then too. I'm not like inappropriate or anything, am I? I know, it's nothing like that. I'm just still getting used to being here, that's all. Yeah. I'm sorry if I'm putting pressure on you or something. I really didn't mean to do like that. Yeah, don't worry. I get that what you're saying. Hi, Hore. Well, anyway, you want to read my poem now? I like the way this one turned out, so I hope you do too. Alright, let's take a look.
Es ist, wie gesagt, man kann sie halt nicht verstehen, weil sie britisch ist, ist in meiner Version und ganz ehrlich, Briten versteht man auch nicht gut. Save me. The colors, they won't stop. Bright, beautiful colors. Flashing, expanding, piercing. Red, green, blue. An endless cacophony of meaningless noise. The noise, it won't stop. Violent, grating. Waveforms, squeaking, screaming, piercing. Sign, cosine, tangent. Like playing a chant board on a turntable, like playing a thingly on a pizza crust, an endless poem of meaningless. Load me.
Finde ich auch super, wie gesagt, das kann ich auch gut sagen. Und load me. Ich habe hier nix, aber und load me. Ich glaube, das ist nicht fertig geworden. Tja, das soll's. It's even more abstract than your last one, huh?
Ho ho, I guess it's all the way ahead. I'm sorry if you don't like it.
No, I never said that. It's just kind of a thing I never really seen before, I guess. I kind of like playing with my space on the paper. Choosing where and how to space your work can totally change the mood of a poem. It's almost like magic. The way I read the lines really sure makes it feel like they're being trying to speak over the knees.
I see.
Still hard for me to tell what's about though.
Oh, sometimes asking what a poem is about isn't the right question. A poem can be abstract as a physical expression of feeling, or a conversation with a leader. So putting it away, not every poem is about something. Anyway, here's Monika writing tip of the day. Sometimes you will find yourself facing a difficult decision. When that happens, don't forget to save your game. You'll never know when you might change your mind, or when something unexpected may happen. Wait. Using my tip even over about writing? What am I talking about?
Oh ha! Hey, that's my advice for today. Thanks for listening.
Yeah.
So, und tatsächlich haben wir es in dieser Folge geschafft, früher fertig zu werden als in meiner letzten. Wir haben jetzt ungefähr 30 Minuten tatsächlich geschafft. Und hier habe ich tatsächlich, bis hier habe ich es gespielt, das heißt, alles, was danach kommt, wäre wieder komplett blind. Und ich werde hier auch tatsächlich die Folge jetzt beenden, deswegen bedanke ich mich natürlich ganz herzlich fürs Zuschauen, für die Leute, die das hier mitgemacht haben. Ich hoffe, von dem Ton passt es dieses Mal alles. Wenn nicht, kriege ich echt einen Kotzreiz. Also wirklich, ich war sehr unmotiviert, tatsächlich jetzt weiter zu spielen mit Doki Doki Literature Club, weil, wie gesagt, ich kannte es schon und es zu blind zu spielen ist natürlich was anderes, als wenn du es schon kennst. Hat man wahrscheinlich auch gemerkt. Oder zumindest merke ich das zu meiner vorherigen Version. Der hat tatsächlich gelöscht, sonst hätte ich die tatsächlich auch nochmal hochgeladen. Aber ganz ehrlich, was soll's. Also ganz ehrlich, wie gesagt, ich hoffe vom Sound und Ton her passt alles. Ich bedanke mich fürs Zuschauen. Ich werde die nächsten paar Folgen oder die nächste und übernächste Folge am Stück aufnehmen. An einem Tag, wo ich eine bessere Stimme habe und tatsächlich motivierter bin, damit ich auch besser vorlesen kann, weil heute, die Stimmen waren heute alle nicht toll. Bin ich ganz ehrlich und dafür entschuldige ich mich natürlich wieder mal. Und ansonsten, wir sehen uns beim nächsten Video. Wir sehen uns beim nächsten Folge Doki Doki Literator Club oder von was auch immer auch. Deswegen, oh, wir save einfach nochmal das Game. Tatsächlich hier waren wir genau. Mache ich jetzt nochmal. So, also ansonsten bedanke ich mich fürs Zuschauen. Wir sehen uns beim nächsten Video. Habt noch einen schönen Tag in der Isolation und bis zum nächsten Mal. Ciao, Leute.